Okay. So warehouse order creation rules used in inbound process as well as outbound process. Okay. So inbound process, we are going to use it very less. Until unless we are going to use it in a put away time. Otherwise, we are not going to use much in inbound area. But we are going to use it in most of the times in outbound to optimize the picking process. Okay. As well as to determine the storage process. Somebody said that to determine the storage process. Okay, let's talk about business example. This is what I said, like optimize the process of picking, put away and internal movements in the warehouse. For this reason, it is important to have an overall understanding of the warehouse order creation in EW and the configuration settings that drive the process. Okay, so based on this, you can understand what is the business example and all this. It is used in picking, that means outbound. It is used in put away, inbound, as well as internal movements of the warehouse. Okay, we'll understand more about this thing. Warehouse order creation overview. So warehouse order is the document that represent an executable work package that a warehouse employee should complete within a specific time. So maybe you can note it down this point. Otherwise, I'm going to give you this document. So, see this? Warehouse order is the document. That document will be having an executable work package. That means it includes some work instructions or work tasks. That is called warehouse tasks. An employee should perform within a specific time. So here in this case, the warehouse tasks are grouped together into warehouse orders and EW makes them available. Somebody, yeah, Antariksh, can you mute so that everybody can, okay. Yeah, mute whoever is not speaking so that, otherwise I'll mute. Okay. Then, when you go to this here, warehouse order creation for the wave management or warehouse order, warehouse request. So, when the group of deliveries are created, a list of deliveries, like delivery, outbound delivery 1, outbound delivery 2, outbound delivery 3, these outbound deliveries, which has the same attributes, are going to be grouped together as a wave. So you can see this. The outbound deliveries are grouped together as one wave. Okay. And based on this wave, when you release the wave, it is going to create warehouse tasks. So somebody is going to ask me a question. But what wave management is not part of inbound. So what is the factor it is going to influence to group multiple deliveries from the same vendor? So how can we combine them? Okay, so we can say that transportation unit is going to be the one TU or vehicle, whatever we are going to say, the one which will help you to combine 2-3 deliveries into one TU, and then you can do unloading tasks and all these things from the TU. So here in outbound, it is going to be a wave. Even internal processes also, wave is going to come into the picture. Based on the wave, numerous warehouse tasks will be created once the wave is released. That means once you say release the wave, outbound delivery, obviously you will be having a, you have to create a pick task. So that pick task for all these deliveries in the wave will be created automatically once you release the wave. So maybe task one, task two, task. And then all the tasks will go through the, here in the, you can see the black box. That is called warehouse order creation formula. That's a black box, okay? It's going to that. And warehouse orders created according to the rules defined in the customizer. Based on that, it is going to combine which task has to go into warehouse order 1, warehouse order 2, warehouse order 3. All these things are defined or will be followed next. Okay. So I'll be giving you step by step what is going to happen. So how warehouse order creation black box is going to work in the real time. So I hope you guys are excited to listen to that. So how the black box is going to create this warehouse order in the outbound process. So first of all, as we see, first thing, in the EWM, warehouse order is the document that represents an executable work package that warehouse employee should complete a specific time, you know that. So that's here, you see the number one, all the warehouse requests are grouped together. That's what we already talked about. So when you go to the next one, so warehouse tasks are created for an open warehouse requests. That means warehouse request 1, outbound delivery 1, and outbound delivery 2, and outbound delivery 3. These outbound deliveries can contain more than one item or one item. So based on this, it is going to create tasks. Task 1, task 2, task 3, and task 4. It is going to create like that. So these many number of tasks. Okay. So once the tasks are created, how it is going to, these tasks represent various activities like picking or put away, or so that resource must perform in the warehouse order to process the warehouse request. So this is the second step, okay? Warehouse tasks are created over here. Third one, once the warehouse tasks are created, they'll be grouped together based on the activity area and the queue. Please remember that, guys. So for suppose 1, 2, 3, 4 tasks are created here. But what happened here is 1, 3, 4 are grouped in this activity area, and then task 2 is grouped in activity area 2. Okay, that is called grouping. Warehouse tasks are grouped together based on the activity area. Activity area means the activity area which is created, the combination of the combination of the bins. We can say that. So embedded EWM determines the activity area of the warehouse task based on the activity area of either the source or destination storage bin and the activity. Okay, whether it is a picking activity or put-away activity, whatever it is going to decide that. You can set the determination of the activity area based on the source or destination bin of the warehouse task by setting the value in the warehouse. WCR activity area in the warehouse process type customization to either source or destination. So the warehouse process type will have this field where WCR activity area, either it is source or destination. Usually for outbound, it is going to be the source, right? For inbound, for put away, I can say it is destination. So it is going to combine like this, the third point, which is talking about here. And then when it comes to the fourth point, so what's happening over here? In the fourth point, okay, you can see it over here. In this, in the next step, EWM looks for the possible warehouse order creation will assign to the activity area. So here you can see activity area AA1 is assigned WCR rule 1 and rule 2, and AA2 rule 3 and rule 4. So this is going to be checked, this one. The fourth point, system is going to check what are the rules are assigned for that activity area. So you can assign the multiple warehouse order creation rules to the combination of activity area and activity and assign them to a sequence for determination. So EWM assigns all the open warehouse tasks to the first warehouse order creation rule in the sequence. That means here, system is going to try to see the as per the sequence, rule number 1 is to be processed first and then rule number 2. So rule number 1, how it is going to be processed, and rule number 2, how it is going to be processed. So if it then looks through the next step for the sorting and filtering to decide the if the warehouse tasks need to be assigned to another warehouse order in the sequence. So here, for suppose there are 4 tasks over here, 3 tasks over here. If the warehouse task 1 failed for the rule 1, and then task 3 and task 4 will check whether rule 1 will be applicable or not. So one is failed, and it will go and again and check for the rule number 2, which is there. Okay, that means for rule number 1, task 3 and task 4 is passed. So that means there is a warehouse order is going to be created or proceed for the next step. And then warehouse task 1, which is failed for rule 1, will check for the rule number 2, whether it is going to be passed or not. Okay, so that's how it is going to check. Then 4th is over, 5th. So in this step, EWM sorts the warehouse tasks in the order defined by the sorting profile. Okay, so this is what it is going to be. It's going to search for the apply filters, limits, and all these things. Then it applies item filters and subtotal filters to the warehouse task to see if it can be processed by the given warehouse or location. It's going to see filters, limits, and packaging profile. I'm going to talk about filter and limits in the next further. So it's going to check what are the applying, what are the item filters, what are the subtotal filters, and then what are the limits. All these things it is going to check. But point number, the last 3 point, any open warehouse tasks that don't meet the filtering criteria are assigned to the next warehouse order creation rule in the sequence for that activity area. Okay, what it is going to do, it is going to go with other one. I think it's something is missing over here. But if it is not meeting the requirement, it is going to go to next warehouse order creation rule. Okay, go to the 6th. In the 5th step, whatever we discussed, EWM assigns the warehouse task to the next warehouse order creation rule in the sequence. Okay, it applies the item filter and subtotal filter on the task assigned to the next warehouse order creation rule until it finds the valid warehouse order creation rule for all open warehouse tasks. Okay, so that means activity area 2 WCRs are there, and it is going to check for all the warehouse tasks, and then it is going to check whether any one of them is applicable. If not applicable, WCR 1 or WCR 2, then it is going to give default rule as undefined. Rule number, default rule is going to give undefined. Okay, rule number 1 is not passing, rule number 2 is not passing, then it is going to go to the undefined. So there is no rule is passed. There is no rule to pass over here. That's what it is going to do. Then 7th, you can see 7th. In this step, EWM sorts the warehouse task assigned to the warehouse order. It's inbound sorting. EWM then uses the sorted warehouse task to check and limit. Okay, what is the limit, warehouse order limit? Often you need to set limit on the warehouse order based on the carrying capacity of the resource. That means one HU can be created with 60-80 kg, something like that. The example is given on here, you can see it. Or if the carrying capacity of the forklift is no more than 80 kg, you need to set a maximum weight of the limit is 80 kg on the warehouse order. If the total size of the warehouse task assigned to the warehouse order exceeds 80 kg, the system then creates a new warehouse order with the same warehouse order creation rule. So meaning, if it is 140 is more than 80, so for 80, it is going to create one warehouse order creation rule, or one warehouse order, and remaining, that is 140 minus 80 is equal to 60, that's 60, right? 60, it is going to create another warehouse order with the same rule, because it can accommodate only 80, and with that 80 plus 60, there are two warehouse orders going to be created with that. Okay, so this is number 7. So see, this warehouse order 1 is created with 1-3 task, warehouse order 2 is created warehouse task 2. So here you can see 1-3-4 it started. Okay, 1-3 used or he 1-3 used in the AA1, but task number 2, here it is in AA2. Okay, So warehouse order created in the AA2 here, two warehouse order number two, and then this is, but you can see warehouse task number four, it's also part of AA2, it created, it take the warehouse task number four, and it was trying to create another warehouse order. So here it says, if the carrying capacity of the forklift is no more than 80 kg, you need to set a maximum weight of limit of 80 kg on the warehouse order. And if the total size of the warehouse task assigned to the warehouse order exceeds 80, the system then create a new warehouse order with the same warehouse obligation. Okay, this is what the 7 and 8, the last one. Now the last one is going to follow packaging profile. In this step, the system creates the required number of handling units using the capacity of the warehouse order and the capacity of the packaging material determined by the packaging profile. So here it is going to take the packaging profile into consideration. The packaging profile is used to creation of the PKQs for the picking, the picked goods, and is assigned to the warehouse order. Okay, that's the last assignment, okay? And finally, the system carries out warehouse order sorting and sorting for the sorting of the warehouse tasks assigned to the warehouse order for execution. You can create a sort rule to sort the warehouse tasks based on the pick path sequence. We'll talk about that a little later. That's how it is going to follow this 8 steps in the warehouse order creation rules. So finally, filters at item level, filters at subtotal level, limit values, inbound sorting, WO sorting, pick HU packing profile, shipping HU packing profile. These are the overview of the rules. That means filters. We are going to talk about what is filters and subtotal filters in the next screens. Limit values, sorting, WO sorting, pick HU packing profile, and CPHU packing profile, we are going to talk about it. So, configuration.
Raja sir.
Yeah.
Sorry to disturb you. Actually, can you please go up previous slide?
Hmm.
So, sure. System also follow the same sequence or is there any?
This sequence, it follows the same sequence.
Okay, sir. That is what my question.
Yeah. Thank you. It follows me. Item level filter, if it is defined, it go and check. If not, it will go to subtotal filter. Subtotal filter, yeah. Item filter and subtotal filter, both are not there. It's going to check the limit values. We'll check that now, okay?
Raju, can you go back two slides where the 0.6 was written?
0.6. Yeah, I'll explain now. You will understand, okay? I'll explain now in the later the... It's only for you. You will come back. Just keep an eye on that, okay? I'll explain that. Just give me a minute. Somebody's asked a question, something like that. Okay, configuration of the warehouse order. You have to do this configuration like this. Next step. Yeah. Can you see this, guys? This is what the configuration of the screen looks like. So this is a warehouse number and warehouse order creation rule and description. What is the category? Item filter, subtotal filter, limit, warehouse orders, inbound sorting, WO sorting, packing profile, shipping profile, and then storage process. Manish, you are asking this question, right? So this is the pattern. Okay, we'll see one by one. We'll see one by one, okay? And then here,
okay.
What is item filter and subtotal filter, how it is going to work. Okay, so we'll see that. Item filter and subtotal filters, okay, you can see that it has the processing time and specifies if complete HU to be removed or partial HU to be removed will be there in this filters. And minimum to maximum weight and its unit, minimum weight and maximum weight will be there in this filters. Maximum value, minimum to maximum number of items for each subtotal level. So all these parameters will be there in the filters. So let's see the configuration screenshot. So here you can see same thing. If you see warehouse number 001 and the filter when we are creating, so here heavy items was mentioned. Heavy items means in this example, heavy item minimum weight is 20, maximum weight is infinite. If you say minimum weight is 20 and maximum weight is infinite kg, that is called, according to this rule, WCR rule filter, it is a heavy item. So you are going to give that minimum weight and maximum weight, minimum volume and maximum volume if needed, or you can give that minimum items for STI, meaning subtotal filter. Okay. If it is selected as a filter at item level, you are going to see this is grayed out. This two is grayed out. But when you select filter at subtotal level, these two fields will be open. So subtotal filter level, how many minimum items should be there? Subtotal means consolidation group level. Okay. Consolidation group level, how many items you can consider to create, I mean, use this filter. But suppose, example, if you are given two items, this filter only consider only two items for that consolidation group. If you select that consolidation group, consolidation group means when the delivery is created, automatically consolidation group also be created or added to the delivery, meaning with this consolidation group, you can control in the packing area. Meaning, you don't want to combine 2-3 deliveries items into one packing area and then do the packing. You don't want to keep two delivery items in the same packing area, packing work center, because it's going to mix. So in that case, you can control not to consider other consolidation group materials into that packing area. You can also define that. So here at consolidation group level, at delivery level, you can say that two items can be taken into consideration to use this filter. That's what you are going to mention that. Okay, minimum items and maximum items, minimum 2 and maximum 4, something like that. So other than that, I talked about which wave category has to be considered, which route. Okay, what is the process type you want to consider this filter? That means usually we are going to use 2010 process type. Some people may be having 2013, 2014, 2015, 2016. So you can control your process type to consider or not to consider. So if you give a 2012, but your inbound, your outbound delivery process, your outbound delivery has 2010. So this filter is going to be not considered because your outbound delivery is having 2010 process type, and here in this warehouse our creation filter is having 2011. So it will skip. It will go to the next filter, something like that. So it's going to do in that way. So here, whether you want to complete HU removal, the previous screen I said, right? Specifies if complete HU will be removed. Okay, that is going to be mentioned over here. And also, it's a reverse, you can mention no put away, no stock removal, no internal stock transfer, no physical inventory. So if you say checkbox, this filter is not going to be applicable for put away. This filter is not going to be applicable for stock transfer. It is not going to be applicable for physical inventory. It's only applicable for stock removal rule. That's how you can control it, okay? So this filter, you define the filters for the warehouse number, and enter a filter for a warehouse order creation rule. Here you select filter type and define your item filters or subtotal filters. Item filter means it's an item level. Subtotal means it is going to be considered based on the consolidation group. So why consolidation group come into the picture? Because you are combining 2-3 deliveries into one wave. 2-3 deliveries, whatever I said, are belongs to same customer. They are going to have same consolidation group. So this 2-3 deliveries can use same filter to proceed further because same customer, deliveries are different. So I can combine both of them. That's how system is going to work with subtotal filters or item filters or here. This is called filters. Then limit parameters in the warehouse order creation loop. So first, as I said earlier, this filter, whether the item is more than 20 kg, yes, this filter is going to pass. If the item is less than 20 kg, is because we mentioned earlier minimum 20, it's not going to pass. That means rule number one is warehouse order creation rule, which I mentioned over here. See this? Where is that? Yeah, warehouse order rule number one. It's try to work with it, but what happened here? It's not going to pass because filter is not meeting the requirement. Rule number one is going to be failed in that case. And then it will go to the rule number two. Some people may be asking, filters are there, limits are there, and then packing profiles are there, and some other parameters are there. If the filters are not matching, will it not go to the other limits and all these things? Yes, it will not go to the limits or inbound sorting and warehouse order sorting, and then packing profile for PKHU, packing profile for ShipHU. All these are going to be skipped. It will go to directly to the next warehouse order creation loop for that warehouse task. Okay. So we learned about filters. Now we are going to learn about limit. Filters are passed. Our subtotal filters are passed. Now we are going to come to the limits. In that limits, limit for physical inventory. Yeah, I can say limit for task. When the limit for task, what is the processing time it is going to consider? And minimum to maximum weight. Minimum to maximum number of items in WO should be. Warehouse order should contain only 3 items or 2 items or 1 item. You are going to mention that. And what is the maximum volume for warehouse order? So based on this, this is the limits screen looks like. So here, limit value, you are going to mention whether it is a warehouse task or PI. This is the one. And then the limit parameters profile contains the size of the scope of the warehouse order. Please remember, this limit parameters consider the size of the warehouse order. But here, this is for warehouse task, this item filters, okay? So, but here, when it comes to here, limit parameters, the size and scope of the warehouse order. Using this profile, you restrict the number of tasks assigned to the warehouse order. So here, minimum items for WO, minimum items per WO, maximum items per WO, items here. At the same time, minimum WTs for HU, maximum WTs for HU. So you can have a field to limit. It's a new field, I think. But otherwise, yeah, you can see this. Maximum consolidation group for warehouse order. Consolidation group means, I said, we saw that filters, right? Subtotal filter, like the same way, 1 consolidation group or 2 consolidation group, 1 warehouse order. And as soon as the value exceeds the defined limit, warehouse order creation completes the current warehouse order with all the warehouse tasks processed to that point in the process. For the remaining warehouse tasks, the system creates other warehouse orders. We already talked about, okay? It's going to follow that limit of this. There's 2 more points over here. So when it comes to here, after the warehouse order creation has checked the values for the maximum limits, it checks the values for the minimum limits. Okay, first of all, it is going to check for the maximum limits. So maximum limits 3, minimum limits 1. So let's minimum limits 2. It's going to check that, then minimum limits. If these limits are not reached, the system cannot process the WTs using the current warehouse allocation rate. Again, earlier it passed the filter, it comes to the limit. If the limit is failing, and then the entire warehouse order creation rule is not going to be processed further. It will go to the rule number 3. Okay. If necessary, the system processes these warehouse tasks using different warehouse orders according to the set sequence in the warehouse order creation rule for each activity area or activity type. That means rule number 1 is passed. Rule number 1 has limits, filters, and then limits. Filter is passed and then it comes to the limit. Even though limit, filter is passed, limit is not passed, it's going to go out of that and then it is going to go with another warehouse allocation rule. Okay, that is the limit parameters. Okay. You can give, you see this minimum WT, minimum items for warehouse order, maximum item for warehouse order, minimum volume, maximum volume, and for the warehouse order, okay, for the warehouse order, all these things you can give that consolidation group, maximum consolidation group for HU, maximum number of HUs, minimum number of WTs, maximum WTs for HU, all these things are there. Next, go to the packing profile. Okay, once it is passed filters and limits, then it is going to the packing profile. In the packing profile, you will be having these fields. Whether it is pack mode is simple or complex, what is going to be the sorting rule over here, and WTs, HUs has to be created automatically, pick HUs to be created automatically, or you want to split the WTs based on the weight and volume and everything, and min to maximum number of items per WO also be part of it. This is the profile. Here you can see this. Okay, simple algorithm or complex algorithm. Simple algorithm means, actually, if you have the packing profile, based on this packing profile, you will be having also a packaging specification with zero BDL. Okay, with zero BDL condition type. So with that condition type, zero BDL condition type, system is going to check if it is simple algorithm, you can have only one packaging specification with packaging material and its weight and volume. Okay. If it is complex algorithm, I'll tell you the complex algorithm, you can have more than one packaging specification with that. Example, but suppose warehouse order creation rule 1 has packing profile XYZ. This is complex algorithm, meaning, so you say that first you say 0 to 30 kg to be packed in a 0 to 30 kg to be picked, I can say, to be picked in a trolley. If it is more than 30, it has to be go to forklift. Okay, more than 30 kg, that means maybe 400 kg or you can say 0 to 400. If it is 400 above up to 1000, it's going to be reached truck. So meaning, I said trolley, forklift, and reach truck. For all these three, you have to create 3 pack specs. Okay, but all 3 pack specs are using the same packing profile, but sequence 1 is trolley, sequence 2 is forklift, sequence 3 is, you can say that, reach truck. So that's a packaging material, you are going to use it to use that pallet or HU. Okay, so that means I can say that trolley contains only 30 kg. That's a HU. One HU can contains only 30 kg. Second one, you can say 0 to 500. That is forklift. So more than that, reach truck may can be, it can also be 1,000 or it can also be same 500, but based on the bin also, you can do that. So that means for same packaging profile, you can have more than one packaging specification to determine your different packaging material. Okay. So in this IMG activity, you will create a packing profile that warehouse order creation can use the determination of the peak handling units for the warehouse order. The system uses the data from the warehouse tasks such as weight, volume, and dimension to perform this determination. It compares this data with the possible packaging materials and determines the number and category of the required handling units. Here you can see this, whether you want to create a HUs and then that HUs to be assigned to the WTs. If you want to split, or suppose there is no further packaging material, that forklift is not there, each truck is not there, you want to split each 30 into one warehouse order for 500 quantity, that means each 30 it is going to create 1111 HU. So then if you have that trolley, you have to carry that trolley many number of times because you don't have the forklift which can carry 500 quantity. So then 30, first one time you go there and then pick that 30 and then come back, maybe another 30, another 30, something like that, you are going to pick something like that. If you wanted to split because you don't have another packaging option. Okay, that's a big HU. Okay. That's how the packaging profile. But I forgot to add few things over here in the warehouse order creation rule. You can also have ship packing profile also for shipping. The same packing profile you can also use for ship HU creation, or you want to create another packing profile, you can also create, and then that means in the packaging area, when you are doing the packing in RF, packaging material will be determined automatically. There is no need to remember what you need to enter. Like some people may be using EWM pallet 1, EWM pallet 2, EWM pallet 3. Maybe in such cases, if it is so and so, we are going to use EWM pallet 1. If it is more than this, EWM pallet 2. If it is more than that, EWM pallet 2, EWM pallet 3. System is going to determine that shipping packaging profile. It is used to determine your automatic HU determination purpose. In the final one, you can see storage process.
Raju, yeah. One query here.
Give me a minute. I'll explain that. In the last and final one, storage process. Sometimes we may want to go to with different processes, maybe picking and value-added services, packing, staging, loading, all these steps you want to follow so that you are going to create a storage process. So that you need to assign as a process-oriented storage control. You can assign it all here for all one. Okay. But other than that, there is a tick mark for determine work center. So please remember, if you are not following POSC, but you want to determine the work center automatically, for one of the reasons you don't want to follow warehouse order creation rules, storage process, but you want to determine the work center by the system itself. So you can say that determine work center tick mark. And then even though there is no OB02 step, still you can determine your work center with this. That's what I can say that. Okay. This is going to be used for in the warehouse order creation rule. Yeah, maybe you can ask the question, Ravinder.
Yeah, okay. See, packing profile, it will determine my pick HU. Okay. Mm-hmm. So, yeah. So, let's say I have 4 pick HUs to bring the material. Then in ship HU, only 2 HU I will use. Okay. So, I need to remove that from the pick HU and then pack it in the ship HU. So, for this, I need to move it to a work center. Or can it be done during, can we do it in, staging bay also?
Not staging bay.
Yes, can be done.
Maybe you can use it. I mean, staging bay is manual. You can also do that, I think, manual. Okay, in the staging bay, you can do it in manual. But okay. In the staging bay, when you are doing the packing, right? So maybe you're not going to use RF, right? Otherwise, I can say when you are using that staging bay in the desktop transaction, I do remember it's going to determine the that HU number automatically. Yeah, it is going to determine. Yeah, staging bay also can be done, but most the ideal way is to go to packing work center.
Yeah, sir, if it is a staging bay, we need to give the starting bin as a staging bay in that Sabre transaction, right? That's only prerequisite, right?
Sorry, can you say that? No, I mean, when it is a staging bay, packaging profile purpose, you have to give the starting bin that where you want to create a pick HU.
Yes.
Yeah, you have to give that, yes.
Sir, I have one question. Like consolidation group, we use not to mix the different customer orders into one warehouse order, right? Mm-hmm. So always it will be like that only, you know, we never used to mix the different customer orders into one warehouse order. So is there any business scenario that we will keep it open that all the customer can be handled in one warehouse order? Is there any business scenarios there, or we always used to restrict that in the consolidation group area?
No, I saw that some clients maybe use that, keep 2-3 customers orders in the same packing work center.
Then the ship handling unit also will have the mix of the orders, cross delivery orders will be there in the ship HU.
Pack work center you can keep it, but while packing, system is not going to allow you to combine other material which has that different consolidation group into the first consolidation group. But otherwise, you can keep it.
See, pick HU is only for picking. You can bring it for multiple consolidation to the pack center. And when you are packing it, okay, the HU, whatever you create, it should be according to the each consolidation group. Okay, it should not like you are going to mix it. Okay. So there you should not allow
but the problem for is the that, shipping. No? Yeah, my question was, if you are mixing it here, no, it's very difficult while repacking it to find the consolidation group and repack it. It won't be that feasible even you have multiple orders in one handling unit, multiple customer orders in one handling unit.
Yeah, I mean, that is exactly right. But what they can do is every time they are having a labels, right? So
yes, sir.
Go to that label and then they will scan it. I can say that order number 1234. So that pick HU label, I can say that HU label will always have that order number. They saw the order number. Okay, that I need to combine this order number 1234 to order number 1234 only. They know that. But by oversight, they scan it for the same HU. It's going to say that I don't allow you to pack it. So then they are going to keep it back.
Okay, sir. Thank you, sir.
Sir Nilesh here. I have a few questions, not one. Sir, where exactly is out of this creation rules, where exactly the grouping will happen?
Activity area. Based on the activity area, first it is going to consider all the warehouse tasks into that activity area. Like example, you have 10 tasks created. 5 belongs to activity area 1 and 5 belongs to activity area 2. So first system is going to check activity area 1 with the activity pick. How many warehouse order creation rules are there? And then it will pass all these 5, rule 1. In that rule 1, it is going to check what is the item filter, whether it is passing or not. If it is not passing, it will go to rule number 2. Understood what I'm talking about?
Yeah.
It's going to be based on the activity area.
But okay, then like Sujan said, like then what about the consolidation? Where that will come into picture?
Consolidation group is delivery level, right? Delivery and customer, those levels.
Now I want to group my tasks according to my consolidation area.
So that is an item subtotal filter. So for suppose you have 3 deliveries, okay? Delivery 1 belongs to customer 1, delivery 2 belongs to customer 2, delivery 3 belongs to customer 3, okay? So 3 deliveries, 3 different customers. So, but you are picking all the metal, all 3 deliveries have the 3 items, 1 item into 1 delivery. You are picking from the same activity area. But when you go through the warehouse order creation rules, which are assigned WOCR1, it will always check if the subtotal filter is active for that warehouse order creation rule. It will check and it will not combine and create two warehouse tasks into one warehouse order. It says one task for one item, right? Example, one task for one item. This one task for one item, if 3 tasks are created for 3 items, 3 items are belongs to 3 different customers or 3 different consolidation groups. So you cannot combine. Even though my trolley capacity is 30 kg, I am picking 10 kg, 10 kg, 10 kg for all 3 customers. Still, it is not going to allow you to combine these 3 warehouse tasks into one warehouse order. Compulsory, it is going to be 3 different warehouse orders for these 3 different tasks. Does that make sense?
Yeah. Oh, okay. Addition is there any way, please forgive me if I'm asking a wrong question. Is there any way that I can keep on activity area and put my grouping on consolidation? Can I do that?
That's a subtotal field, right?
Yeah, probably. I have not good in this WCR actually. So that's why I'm asking this question.
Yeah.
Like mostly I want to group all my tasks according to my consolidation, like my customer. And my W should get created according to that.
No, that's a subtotal filter. Give that subtotal filter one STI. Here we mentioned, right? Here. Where is that? Yeah, here. There is a field called minimum item for STI.
STI is subtotal.
Subtotal filter.
Okay. Okay, is there any precedence here, sir? Is there any order in which this gets executed, these filters? Like if I say I have, this is not item, I'm talking about this limits. Can you go to the limit slide?
Mm-hmm.
The previous one. Yeah, this one. Okay, I've been told that the client has told me that, okay, I should have minimum 10 items and the maximum of 20 tasks in one warehouse order. So what if there is a conflict that happens, like there are 5 items, my 20 tasks were created. So how the precedence takes place in this case, which is considered first, whether it's number of items or it's number of tasks?
Both number of items, and then are you going to give that minimum task? Minimum task is not there, right? Minimum items for W, minimum items you have given 5 in the configuration. And maximum number, minimum WDs for HU. Okay, see this, minimum WDs for HU. But there's no concept called minimum task for WO here. Is that there, somewhere here? Is only for HU, that one it was mentioned. Minimum WDs for HU, maximum WDs for HU.
Okay.
Got the point?
Yeah, I got you. Yeah.
Maybe you have 5 items, it is passing. 5 items, it is passing. But the thing is, but while it is creating a HUs, you are going to consider that one HU for 5 WTs. That means if you have 5 items, 25 tasks, it is only considered 5 WTs and create one warehouse order, another 5 in another warehouse order, another HU. 5 WTs in 1 HU, 5 WTs in 1 HU, 5 WTs in 1 HU. Like that, it is going to create 5 HUs if you have 25 tasks for 5 items.
This HUs, this
that is for Pikachu, no, sir? Is it for Pikachu that HUs is?
Yeah, this HU we are discussing, which is what? This minimum WTs per HU, maximum WTs per HU. These HU is what? Like, is it receiving HU or which HU?
Pikachu. That's a trolley. Trolley and the trolley. Pikachu. Trolley is a HU, right? At this moment. For
yeah, yeah. Okay.
Yeah.
And so this subtotal filter will, sir, and the subtotal filter will always come for the consolidation group only, right? The subtotal filter.
Correct. Yes.
Okay. Yeah.
Raju, two more points. Yeah, I had messaged that one. Yeah, see, can we limit the warehouse task of one bin only? I don't see anywhere that one. So I'm just asking, is there any workaround or something? Like, okay, if I have one bin. See, if I have a bin A, okay, and there are like 50 quantity, okay, and bin B again 50 quantity, okay. So whenever, though my warehouse order limit, okay, if I say 100 kg, 100 numbers also, then I should, it should, based on the bin, it should create two warehouse orders rather than one warehouse order. Okay, so I'm telling the system that, okay, based on the quantity available in the bin, okay, you limit your a number of warehouse tasks for that, okay.
So, I mean, so that dynamic is for H, minimum WTs for HU, you can do that, right?
Yeah, minimum WT, but see, let's say now my bin, I am having only 20, okay, so maximum is 50, but now it is only having 20, okay, sometimes it might be having 30, okay, based on that, the system should automatically change, like, okay, I am creating the this one based on this, anyway, it will go for the source bin, okay, wherever our destination bin, if it is going for source or destination, so it should check, okay, I am going to create it for this destination bin and the quantity is only 30, okay, now I should go for the next warehouse order and I should create it for that one, okay, so.
Yeah, so you can
like this.
You can make it as a minimum WTs per HU is maximum number of HU is one for this limit, and then minimum WT is one or maximum WT is one per HU.
Okay.
So only one WT, yeah, because if you are picking from two different bins, the two tasks, right? It is picking from two bins.
Correct. Two different tasks will always get created. Yes.
So one task, one HU, and one warehouse order. It is going to be created like that. So maximum number of HUs one for this limit, and then minimum WTs per HU is maximum WTs per HU is one. That's it. It limits that warehouse task.
Okay.
Okay.
So for each bin, okay, let me try that. Yeah.
And in the package, we have simple and complex algorithm also. So complex means we have multiple dimension packaging material. So we want to choose one of it. That is the only option for the complex algorithm in the package.
Yes. Yes.
Okay. Simple means it will always takes a single packaging material.
Only one.
Okay.
Only one pack profile. That is always you see. Usually in the down level, below, lower level, level one, you can go ahead and take that your trolley with maybe multiple HUs, multiple 30 kg, 30 kg, 30 kg, something like that. So in that case, what you can do is in the down level, you can give a simple.
Okay. Mm-hmm.
And then if it is above level number two or level number three, if you want to pick it up with in a different way,
different packaging material,
packaging material, and all these things, you can consider that second packaging material, and third packaging material, fourth packaging material, multiple.
Okay, thanks.
It's always based on your
capacity, dimension capacity of the product,
as well as your
dimension, weight, volume of the product, right?
Mm, yeah. Mm-hmm.
Raju, one more question. Like, see, for PKHU creation, there is nothing like a Veros task is created, right? See, in the Veros task, whatever is created, there will be one PKHU created. Okay, but in our project, I see that whenever there is a Veros order created, okay, I see that PKHU is created with a Veros task itself. Okay, so it will be a HU Veros task.
This one.
Okay.
Assign WTs to HUs.
Okay.
This checkbox is there now. Based on that, it is going to assign. You cannot delete that HUs automatically until unless you cancel the warehouse task. It will create the HUs and then if it will assign to the WTs. Sometimes what I wanted to do is delete that PKHU creation and then I want to create a new one. It is not possible. It says
okay.
So
it will create assign Veros task to HUs, but what exactly is the request? See, create HUs is it will only create this PKHU. Okay, then assign Veros task to the HUs is like
whatever the HUs are created based on the packing profile that will assign to the warehouse tasks. Task one, task two, one PKHU. Task three, task five, another PKHU. Task 4 and task 6, another PKHU. That's how it is going to assign.
Yeah, correct. But what is the advantage of that? Why? See, anyway, I will put, see, I am having one warehouse task. Okay, I have a 30 quantity. Okay, that needs to be packed in one HU. So I have created one PKHU. Okay, not through a warehouse task, but okay, just one HU, like we create manually, we can create one HU. Okay, so that is create HUs. But here, there will be enough for PKHU itself, there will be one warehouse task created and it will be auto confirmed only. It will be auto confirmed. In the backend, it gets auto confirmed.
No, auto confirmed is a different option, but I'll tell you why it is going to assign to the HUs. But suppose I have an item, my PKHU, all PKHU create, three PKHUs are created with HU capacity is 30 kg, 30 kg, 30 kg. Okay. So, first item is exactly 30 kg. That means one HU, one task. And second item is having 18 kg. And fifth item is having 12 kg. So, second and fifth is going to be combined while picking that second item, compulsory it will ask you to pick fifth item also because exactly 30 kg it is going to match for that HU. That space utilization of that two materials into that pick HU is possible by doing this assign WTs to HUs. And third and sixth will be assigned to the third pick HU, something like that. So that's how it is going to be created and assigned to the HUs. So, but auto confirmation of the task, you are saying that pick tasks are confirmed automatically, right?
Yeah, that PKHU, whatever it is created, okay, it is created with the warehouse task, okay. So that is auto. Anyway, the HU remains open. And what we are doing is, see, whenever I am using that PKHU to pack, okay, I will close it and again I will create a new PKHU. Okay, in that the RF transaction, okay.
No, that is it. You will close it and create a new pack HU, not the pick HU.
No, we create PKHU only in our, I don't know, but that is where I am asking, like, whether it might be a complete customer. What happens, see, I will, not a trolley, okay, you can say trolley, but ours will be like open trolley kind of, okay, plain surface, and I am going to have multiple boxes, okay. So then I will check. Then decide, okay, no, this is not enough. Okay, I will close one PKHU. Then I will immediately create one more PKHU. Okay, and for me, the system will always ask whether you want to place it back to the staging bay or not. Okay, whether when I say that this is complete, system will ask me whether you want to place it to the staging bin. If I say no, then it will again, I can create a new PKHU so that I can create four PKHUs. And then there will be different material in that. And then in the end, if I say that, okay, now you go to the staging bay, then all the four will be moved to the staging bay, and again the same worker can come and continue working with the other same warehouse order. There might be 50 warehouse tasks, 10 warehouse tasks he moved to staging bay, then again 40 are remaining, then again he will continue working with that. Okay, so the completely dynamic. So custom, how much standard? So I was just analyzing that case. Okay, so it is completely dynamic in our
Check that whenever you are, I mean, maybe that's kind of a development it seems, but usually whenever you are creating any what you call PKHU, that PKHU will never be deleted. You always have to proceed picking confirmation to the staging area or packing bin. Once you reach the packing bin, you can delete that PKHU and then create a new PKHU, create a new shipHU. But otherwise, the deletion of the PKHU while picking may not be possible. So maybe
we have an option. Yeah, we to select a different pack material. Okay, in the RF only. I have an option. See, PKHU will get created with certain packaging material. Okay, but I have in RF. Okay, I don't want to use that box. Okay, because okay, there will be many different sizes boxes. Okay, something is not available. What I will do is I will use a different packaging material. I will create a different PKHU, and then I will fill it up and I will take it to the staging bay. Okay, so complete dynamic. It is not like everything is fixed.
Silicon overwrite, no, Robin? You can't overwrite in the RF, change the packaging material?
That's what you're saying, yeah. I think
that is what I'm telling. It is completely dynamic in our case. Okay, see, whatever is there, yeah. I have not seen the standard screens, okay? It's been like 2.5 years, okay? So I don't know whether it is standard, whether it is not a standard, what exactly, so these questions.
That is exception case. Maybe they are using exception case to, I mean, 30 kg, we are picking into 3 HUs. Instead of that, use a big HU and then use all 90 kgs into 1 HU and then move it to packing work sector. That's what you are
saying. Yeah, exactly. That is what. Okay. So you can show the totes. Okay. Let's say totes. Okay. Totes might be of 10 kg, 30 kg, 40 kg. Okay. He will go to that area, then he will find that, okay, the tote whatever is available is of 40 kg, not 20 kg. Okay, then he will change that. He will take that 40 kg tote and then he will fill it up everything. Okay, he will put and he will move it. So it's all like a dynamic. Okay, so yeah. I just wanted to know how much is.
I saw that in my previous project where we can change the packaging material. Even I don't remember whether it is in there. Maybe you may be right.
And one more thing, do we always need a pack spec? Do we always need a pack spec? Can I create HUs? Is there anywhere I can default
manually
for
can
few?
Create,
okay, for
yeah,
few.
Manually can create pack
spec. No, manually. No. Uh-huh. I'm not telling manually. See, if I am having material A, then always my pack spec will be this one. Okay, for 10 materials, I will tell that, okay, your pack spec is this. For another 10 materials, I will say that this is the pack spec, okay? So based on like that, okay? Is there anything like I don't want to have the pack spec, but packing material?
Yeah, you can default the packaging material based on the work center. There is an option called the work center. You can give the packaging material, but every time it is always proposed as the same packaging material. If you use that in what is it, T work ST transaction, you can use that. You can default it.
Which one?
There is a transaction called
T work ST.
T work ST transaction is there, na?
Okay.
Box center bin, you are going to maintain that, right? Or there. So
yeah.
There you can default. I mean, if you double click that line item, because you are going to T work ST, you are going to enter the bin. Instead of bin, while entering the bin, you double click on that line. It is going to open the form view. In that form view, you can give the packaging material also. With that packaging material, it is going to default automatically for that work center. I mean, every time that packaging material is it can be defaulted, or you wanted to change it, you can change it.
Okay.
There's an option, okay? T work ST.
Okay. And one basic question now. The trolley, okay, I saw in HANA 1909 above onwards. Okay, if you want to define a trolley with compartments, how many compartments? Okay, SAP has come up with a nice feature that, okay, you can define number of compartments also now. Okay, and you can create. Okay, if you create one main HU will be there, that is a trolley. In that trolley, if there are 20 compartments, I can define how many compartments for that, and I can give that compartments, and I can create that compartments for. Okay, so that trolley with compartments. Okay,
that will be a sub HU, I think so. Kind of nested HU.
Yeah, correct. Sub HU only. Sub HU. You can say like nested only. Okay, you can say like nested only. Okay, now when I create those compartments, okay, is there a way that I can say that only A material can go in compartment 21, B material can go only in, so is there any mappings, something like that, if anyone has worked? I am not sure. Okay, so this is 1909.
Yes, last project we were also having this compartment in the trolleys, but we don't cannot control which product goes into the which compartment. That in standard, no? Standard, they have not given that functionality. Maybe Raju sir and anyone can tell. But what based on my experience in previous project, we don't have that control of which product goes to which compartment inside the trolley.
Yeah, that is, see, inside the trolley, okay, it's fine, okay, but in the compartment, when I am creating the compartments, okay, I know how many compartments are something I am going to create. So based on that, okay, I'm not sure how many of you know this trolley, this one. Okay, if someone is interested to check, okay, you can check these two T codes. Okay, this is very interesting. Okay, recently I found it out.
Can you be sharing it on chat?
Yeah, that is what I'm sharing those two. Okay, this is where you define the compartments. Okay. This is the T code where you define the compartments. And
not aware of this.
And one more T code I will just give you. Because you need to create the handling unit with the compartments, right?
Yeah.
So
packaging material will be trolley.
But where exactly you, in which, which industry we have this kind of thing? Like, we require
for spare parts.
For us, retail industry, we also.
Yeah, you have a capacity of 300 kg, but you wanted to divide into compartments. You can use that here.
We also to the retail industry. We don't require actually compartment. Like, you can simply dump that material in that car.
But we were using compartments in my previous projects. I don't
see how we use compartments might be okay. I'm not sure. Okay, see, there will be 10 different customer orders. Okay, so I will place each one order material in one compartment. Okay, so I have a trolley. Okay, why it is like that, I will tell you. Okay, the industry I am working with. Now, there is a machine that requires, okay, these are all home appliances or something. Okay, so someone has got some parts that needs to be replaced or something. So each order will have one spare parts or something like that. So whenever I keep them, I will keep them in certain compartments only, and I will take them, and based on that compartment, directly it will tell you, I can segregate them easily. Okay, first I will, for all the 50 orders, I will take one trolley, bring them at one place, then I will start segregating them. Okay, this compartment item is for this order. Okay, this compartment item is for this order, something like that we do.
Yeah,
this is
when you use the HU, how you
press
the HU
here
in this
case? Sir, we are using the second one, sir. Picking trolley
warehouse,
no?
No, trolley itself is a HU.
This one.
Trolley itself is a HU.
Yeah, this is the one we are wearing, similar to this. Bigger one.
Cage one.
In the here, compartments are there, right? This is also a kind of
cage to dispatch the material to the source, right? It remains stable. It remains in the proper position.
And see, while reading this one, I stumbled upon something. Now SAP has come up. It was in a long pending development from the SAP. For production.
This is the one, sir. Mm-hmm. Yes. Go ahead. Sorry.
For production, there will be trolley or something. Okay, that vehicles will be used with like a train kind of a thing. There will be multiple bogies attached. I don't know how many of.
How many have seen that? It's kind of a train, multiple bogies are there.
Like a train it will be, okay. Like a train, okay, warehouse will be a little far away from the your production, this one. And it will be like a train, everything will be put into that. And then it will be taken to those, production lines. And then it will be distributed,
like this,
okay.
Like this.
Exactly. All four are connected, yes. So for this, SAP has come up with a new feature. Okay, if someone is, that is distributive equipment. Okay, SAP is calling it as distributive equipment.
Rajesh, a $1 million question for me. How you design one AWS here?
How you
design one? Like if I'm given a requirement, then how I should start to just know to define one AWS here?
Yeah, I mean, if you have given, like in my previous company, I said they are saying that I have a trolley like this, okay? So in this 30 kg, 30 kg, 30 kg, 30, 30, 30, 30, 30, 30, like there are like this, and then total 9 HOs. Now, when I'm picking the material from the lower level, I always use this trolley, okay? 9 in this side and 9 other side. So one warehouse order will have 18 HUs, and then I'm going to take this trolley, and then I'm going to pick HUs. First of all, I'll be labeling all here, HU1, HU2, HU3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18. And then if the system proposes to keep the HU1, I'm going to keep it all here. If the next one is, immediately it is going to finish the HU1. And then it will go to HU2, and then it is go to HU3, something like that. So based on your warehouse manager says, lower level I'm going to pick with this trolley so that my warehouse order should contain, one warehouse order should contain 18 HUs. Each HU can contain only 30 kg. So based on that, you have to create one filter. How much weight is there here? 30 × 9.
270 into 2.
Okay. Mm-hmm. Maybe 540, right?
540.
So my 540 kg can accommodate here in this. One warehouse order contains 540 kg. But suppose it contains only 20. Okay. The another 10 kg I cannot able to accommodate any of them. So this HU1 will be only 20. The another 10 may not be over here because that 10 I cannot able to split. So it may be 29 kg. 1 kg is missing. It may be 24 kg. That cages are missing. So you can also make sure that maximum weight of 24 kg your warehouse order, 540 kg is your warehouse order. But each HU cannot be more than 30 kg. It can be.
It's complex, complex algorithm. And Raju sir, I have one question. So normally when you create a pick HU, the label also will get generated based on the packaging material. So in the physically in the warehouse, no, where they keep this printer for the pick HU in the work center or how they and what are they going to scan it in the pick HU after the label is generated? In the what are the scanning things they will do with the pick HU? Can you tell that part, sir?
So usually, where I see with my previous company, this warehouse tasks are, as in when the warehouse orders are created, they are going to take that nearby packing work center. They are going to use this printer, and the packing work center is very near to the racks itself. So this guy, warehouse supervisor, will be there. That guy is going to take out all the printouts, and then he is going to keep that on the trolley. whatever the labels he printed. No?
Okay. Uh-huh.
Okay. Keep that on the trolley. That trolley contains all these warehouse orders. Maybe that warehouse order, the trolley is going to
items for the warehouse order. Uh-huh.
Exactly. Maybe Abhi, you can tell that word based on your how you are going to use in your warehouse.
And how are they going to scan that once? Yeah, that also can tell us. Yes.
I mean, like just based on trolley, we are going to use it. Yeah. Abhishek, are you there? You're sleeping.
No, not sleeping.
No, not Abhishek. Abhishek actually. Abhishek, he is the one who is warehouse. He is handling the warehouse. Yeah, Abhishek, if you are also handling the warehouse with the trolleys and everything, you can also explain.
Yeah, what you are talking about just now, we call it each picking.
Each picking, okay.
Each picking, and we call the one who is handling it as an order picker.
Hmm.
So he has these multiple trolleys. So he is going and he is collecting one by one. He's placing it one by one in bin and then feeding the production packing line. So labeling what was asked, what we have a receipt area.
Mm-hmm.
Then there is a pre-packing. After that, it is a put away. And then picking packing. So near to the pre-packing area, we have the labeling.
Okay.
Or the for outbound picking.
For outbound
picking.
Yes. When exactly you guys print the labels in this case, like everything we are just talking at the system level, but when exactly the printing happens of the pick labels in this case?
The wave is created, and the pick tags are created in the system.
Automatically. After wave is released, yeah.
So we print the pick tags. So maybe there are
pick tags and Pikachu, right?
Pikachu. Now, I'm not very familiar with the warehouse terminology, but practical what is happening, I'll tell you. So you call it as a Pikachu. Suppose 100 tags are generated, 100 tags are printed. So the supervisor hands over the tags to the material handler, maybe the reach truck driver who is going to pick the material.
Okay.
So what he does, so suppose there are 100 tags and there are 6 zones. So first he arranges it zone-wise.
Zone-wise, correct.
Okay. He arranges it zone-wise and starts picking the one which is nearer. Suppose we have 3 RT drivers and there are 6 zones. So each one is assigned with 2 zones.
Yeah, zones means activity areas. Okay. Yeah.
So activity areas.
So 100
all the aisles.
100 label means 100
pick 100 pick tags. 100 pick tags.
100 pick tags. Okay.
Means he has to go to 100 locations.
Yes. Okay.
Which are in 3 different zones. So I have 3 RT drivers. So I, as a supervisor, arrange it zone wise. Hand it over to the RT drivers of 3 zones. And then he goes and picks it.
Yeah.
And confirms and then gives to the packing line.
Okay.
It's like even the routes can be mentioned. Okay. Yeah, inside warehouse, again, there can be routes. Okay. So one picker will take one route, another picker will take another route. Okay. Right. So based on, each bin, which activity, there can be from multiple activity areas, okay? So it is not only one activity area, multiple activity area, then okay, all combine one route, okay? So again, it depends on routes. There are many complex features that can be added, yeah.
Right. And once they bring that to the work center, they will scan that Pikachu and...
They will scan that Pikachu,
mm-hmm.
and once the Pikachu is scanned, the destination label is printed.
Okay. Shipping label will be printed.
Shipper label.
Pikachu is not the final one. Yeah. Again,
Pikachu is for the picker.
Only for picking. Yeah. That's
yeah. And shipping label is for the customer to, it is the destination label.
Final HU label.
Yes. You can have the same Pikachu as a ship HU. Okay.
Yeah, even, yeah,
if it is not
Pikachu. Yes. We have our Pikachu as our ship HU.
Yeah. Yes. It
so
can.
What,
it can.
What
be.
You
okay,
call
it, can
we call it as a super HU. Means that is the final one.
What exactly you are using, okay, that pick HU you may using only internally in your warehouse, and then you will it's like one big trolley. Okay, it is one big trolley. You are taking all the way and you are putting everything. Then you will come to that packing station, and there you are going to create the ship HUs, different ship HUs, and then you are going to distribute all the material, and then you will send it. Okay, so it depends what exactly.
Business so one on business. I'll just explain in more detail.
Yeah, yes.
There is one pick tag, that is pick HU, what you call. So which it is assigned in maybe zone A1. So it contains 6 cases. So I go to the zone, I pick the 6 cases. Cases means boxes. So I pick the 6 boxes, I give it to the packing line, and I hand that over to the scanner. So the scanner will scan the pick HU. And since there are 6 boxes, 6 destination labels will be printed and pasted on the box.
That scanning will be happening in the floor, in the once picking itself, right? The RF scanning, picking RF scanning, right? This is
No. Yes. Picking RF scanning is different. Okay. That is for the picker. Once he picks it, he scans it and confirms it that I have picked it.
Ah, right. This is okay. Bringing it to the work center, you are scanning it, right?
Right.
Okay. And you're doing the RF only, right? That also?
RF. Yeah, RF. Right. RF.